Sinatra, Alexa, a sonata, prepare me tomato. Anticipation in the air for this one. Hi, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Sabolski for EA Sports. You ready for a game tonight? Looking forward to this one tonight. And there's the puck drop. Enough talk. It's time to find out what this is all about. Nowhere for that shot to go through. Keeps hold of the puck. He scores! The captain leading by example!
That's some slick passing right there. There's not much room to thread that pass onto the tape, but it's perfect. And the shooter just has to capitalize.
Philadelphia's essentially taken the crowd out of this one early.
They've changed the whole context of the game with that early goal.
Sends it in on the attack. Philadelphia's got a hold of it along the wall. Justin's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Look out, they can create some trouble here. Extra attackers on the ice with the delayed penalty looming. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
You can actually gain a little momentum here if the penalty killers do the job. Down a goal, if they kill this, you're going to have some jump.
Well, this gives us our first chance to take a look at the team's power play unit.
Well, the power play gets to dust itself off here. First opportunity tonight.
Here's a clearing attempt. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
Quick pass to Fisher. Centering pass! Oh, there's going to be a regret in this one. That might... Scores! Well, the goaltender's going to want to have that one back. He put it in himself.
Rewarded with a point there, guys, but he did win that battle for the loose puck, and that's his no-contest superstar ability. It's that hard work to get possession that helped the team create that scoring chance.
The Hurricanes played along the boards, and that pass attempt is deflected. Here's a shot! Scores! That's three unanswered now!
Oh, there seems to be no way to stop them. They got one, and it seemed like the momentum just changed so far in one team's favor.
It's a snowball effect now.
He pounded this low stick side. The goalie can't get his pad on it. It's in the net.
It's so impressive to watch how quick his hands are. And this time it helps the team out getting an assist on the board as they put one in the back of the net. It's his puck on a string zone ability that allows him to stick handle so well and get around the opposition.
Takes the feed. Moves the puck more to the middle.
On the doorstep. Scores! What a finish! Like the little engine that caught!
It's really amazing, James, to watch this play, and you never really think of all the work that goes into making a player good or making them special. You work on balance and agility, you saw it right there. Fight the puck all the way to the net, and it's in the back.
To defend against him because he's so hard to knock off the puck. His unstoppable force zone ability is exactly what we've talked about, guys, and what allowed him to put the puck in the net this time.
Here's a short pass to Poe. Into the corner now. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Here we go, odd man rush here. Picking up some steam at center ice. The Rockets get a hold of the puck in the open ice. And he takes a shot. Denies him on the play. Play whistle dead. Penalty coming up.
That's an easy one, James. That's a trip every time.
Kelowna's man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
You want to win the special teams battle almost every night. Well, the power play's first chance to check in here. We'll see what they can get done.
Kelowna's got a hold of the puck now. Great pass from the left wing up the middle now. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play.
This power play hasn't had a chance to really get much set up. They can't get into the zone with any consistency. Now they're back, and they got to start again.
And they send it down the ice. One-timer! What a stop as he puts out the fire! Hasek's got the puck, and he's going to go for the whistle here.
He hasn't had a lot to do this period, but he's been excellent and has been able to control the pace of play.
Jagr's ready to take the draw here on this power play. Kelowna's got it in the offensive zone. Blocked in traffic.
Boone's ready to join the play.
The Hurricanes PK unit delivers on that.
The only positive for the power play there is they didn't have to skate up and down the ice. They didn't generate anything. They had it in the zone, but really, nothing very good about it.
Tries to feed it over to Lamb. Takes the pass. Slides it back to the blue line. Oh, what a block. He'll get a pat on the back from the coach when he gets off, if he can get off. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. And he makes the save.
Oh, he's going to shake his head at that one. He always seems to score from in tight.
That get was many chances coconuts.
Here's a chance out front, and they can't convert on the play. And we're going to get a face-off after the offside. Past the halfway mark of this period, been a pretty good offensive display, at least for one side. 3-1 is where we sit. From the point, looks to make something happen. Slides it across to Fowler. Oh boy, here's trouble. 2-on-1. He was right there, and they can't convert. And they cough it up in the neutral zone.
The Rockets have stolen a bunch of pucks tonight, and I'm telling you, James, in a close game, this easily could be the difference.
Puck grab by Coffey. Takes a wrist shot. That goes off the post and stays out.
Kelowna's really grinding on this game. They want to get this game back to even, but that shot off the post won't help them.
And that one's broken up. Great block there. And makes the save. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. The Hurricanes have it behind the net. Sends a pass over. We've got icing on the play. Faceoff coming up. Here in the later stages of this period, Philadelphia's got a 3-1 lead. Fishers won a big draw on their own end.
After the icing, there's a little more pressure on the centerman to win the draw.
Takes a shot, and that's blocked. Doesn't go. Scooped up along the wall by Esposito. Moves it to Fisher. Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. And that's just out of reach. Shuts him down.
Patrick's strength is technically, he is outstanding. Here's a save, and the puck's in the corner.
Here he is, shot right in front. Oh, no, luck as it goes off the outside of the post. Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Fisher's won the draw here in the offensive zone. There's the horn, ending the first period. Both teams will have a chance to regroup. You do you, and we'll be back with period number two in a moment. Ray Ferraro bringing you all the action. Period number two is about to go. Well, after an intriguing opening period, here we go. It's period number two. Puck is dropped and we are underway. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
The Rockets are going to have to find a possession game that looks a lot different than that first period. They chased it around, and as a result, they're chasing the game.
Esposito's lugging the puck. Quick feed to Fowler. And we'll get a breather here with offside the call. Lots of time left in this period. 3-1 is where we're sitting. Fans being treated to a lot of offense thus far. Fisher's won possession. Sends the pass over. The Rockets get a hold of the puck in their own end. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. Let's it go. And he comes up with it.
Lots of strong push games across the net to make the save.
Can't get it to go. Routine save made by Hasek. Great heads-up play to poke it away in the offensive end. There's the whistle icing the call. Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another face-off here. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. From center, they get into the attacking area. And he makes the easy save. Kelowna's got the puck in the defensive end. Dishes it to Bull. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Moves it quickly over to Fisher. And we'll reset things after that icing. More than half the period left to play. Philadelphia's got a 3-1 lead as they have dominated for the most part in this. Moves the puck to the attacking area. Centering pass. Let's get the call. Fisher's going off for interference. Kelowna's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
Just because the power play hasn't had a success run here, you can't focus in on that. You can't try to do too much. Move the puck the way that you practice. Get people to the front of the net. It's really a simple equation.
The Rockets gain possession. Moves it around along the half wall. He tries to tuck it in. Right in the low slot. Looking to clear the defensive zone. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here.
Well, that's their job. Get it down the ice. Get off the ice. Get some new people out there.
Moves the puck along the half wall. Sends it down low. Here's a chance. Oh, just wide of the net.
From my angle, that looked like it was going in. He just misses that wide.
Comes up with the stop. And the man advantage fails to pay off as both teams are back at even strength.
It'd be pretty hard to have a more low-intensity power play than that. It really didn't generate a thing, and when you don't generate much, you're sure not going to score.
Up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it. And a strong defensive effort to get in front of that.
Oh, he laid a solid hit on him there. He was waiting for him and laid the shoulder right into him.
That might loosen a few of the choppers on that play. Here in the back half of this period, it's a two-goal lead we're looking at with the score 3-1. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Cologne has gained possession along the boards. And that one's broken up. Broken up with a stick. And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play. Can't connect. With authority. Feeds the puck to Fowler. Moves it over to Justin. Tosses it on to Fowler. Puck knocked loose in the neutral zone. The Hurricanes gain possession along the wall. Angles it over to Fowler. Philadelphia's got the puck against the half wall. Scores! Kaboom! What a shot! Nobody was stopping that one-timer.
Perfect. I mean, James, I think you could probably receive that thing. It's right in the middle of the blade, flat and crisp. Off they go.
And both centers glide into the dot as a faceoff set to resume. Fisher's won the draw here in the neutral zone. They go on the attack through center. A shot! Gets a glove on it to make the save. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. Here in the late goings of the period, the Hurricanes now lead by 3. Philadelphia's won the faceoff. Can't finish. Oh, Ray, blown opportunity.
It really is. I mean, the play is sitting right there. There's a scoring chance to be had. They just don't execute it.
Oh, and that's got the crowd buzzing after that stop.
Really good save. Control the rebound. Get it into the corner where you can reestablish yourself.
And they can't connect. The Hurricanes gain control of the puck against the wall. Throws it on goal. Makes the save.
There's a trademark there. He's not going particularly fast, but he has this way of finding open ice, going to the net. I don't know how he does it, but there's another scoring chance.
Quick pass to Fowler. And that's a great heads-up play in the offensive zone. He let that one after the whistle.
Fisher's
temper's flaring.
Yeah, a little bump together, a little friction. Looks like the guys want to get it going. Fisher's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
The Hurricanes get a hold of the puck off the draw. Colonna's got a hold of it against the wall. Big save in front.
Excellent chance. They work the puck into position, and it's a scoring chance that's turned away.
And no luck on that pass attempt. Scooped up along the wall by Boog. And that's blocked! And that concludes the second period of play. Still one more period of regulation time. We'll see what happens in the third next. And we are just moments away from the start of the third period. Third period underway here. This has been a total squash to this point. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
Cologne has been a step slow almost all game. They haven't had the puck very much. They're losing. If that's going to change, they've got to get the puck and hold on to it much more.
Can't complete the pass as it goes off a stick. And there we go. Icing is the call. We're still in the early stages of this period, and we've got a 4-1 hockey game. Philadelphia's won the draw.
Hey, maybe you can create some offense against the tired team after the icing.
Directed over to Fowler. Puck scooped up by Coffey. Takes it to the net. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
Hey, sometimes the goalie just beats him, and that's a quick release. He's known for that. But the goalie's on top of it and makes the stop.
Great reach with the poke check. And that one's picked off. Stones him in front.
Now, by being in the right position, James, he gets out tight to the shooter. There's nowhere for the puck to go.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. And the intensity's starting to ramp up here after that hit. And offside, we'll get a reset here. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period, the Hurricanes are giving their fans a lot to cheer about tonight as they lead it 4-1. And they turn it over in the neutral zone. Here we go, one-man rush. And that pass is redirected. And now it's over to Bull. Slides it across. Takes the feed. Dished on over to Fisher. Right up front. Can't connect. The Rockets have it now. That's moved up ahead. Swatted away with the stick in the defensive zone. Kelowna's got possession here in the neutral zone. And that pass goes off a stick. Kelowna's got possession of the puck. That's blocked. And that's poked away. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Kelowna's got the puck. Here's a short pass to Bull. And that goes wide of everything. With possession along the wall. Oh, he'll feel that one. Slides it over to Fisher. Moves the puck. Blocked in front. Takes a shot. Oh, what a stop.
I think he's all right, but really, like, who are we to say? We're standing here in a suit. I mean, he just took a puck flying that fast right in the face. I hope he's okay.
And that's deflected. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. Dumped into the cross side. Philadelphia's got the puck along the wall. Moves it to Fowler. Sends it over. Esposito's taking it from his own end. Penalty coming up here.
There are times you can see that interference penalty, James, coming from a mile away. That one was pretty obvious.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. And the puck clears the zone. Kelowna's got the puck in their own end. Picked off by Coffey. Nice job to escape the zone. Oh, set that hit up perfectly. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. Taken along the wall by Fowler. No room for that one to get through. And he easily stops that one. Feeds a Bull. On the one-timer, and a great save.
Hasek's
goaltending at one end and the offensive output at the other has made for a good night.
And a solid effort by the penalty killers as we are back to even strength.
Well, the only thing that happened on that power play was the clock rolled along. Very few chances, not much danger.
Just here in the late stages of this frame, Philadelphia's got a little more jump in their step tonight. They lead it 4-1. From in close! And the puck dies with the trapper save.
We often talk about a goalie's reflexes. You've got to have quick hands to make a glove stop like that.
Some last-second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. The Hurricanes will go to work here in the offensive zone. Big-time stop there. We got a whistle as the puck's frozen. Yager's won it off the faceoff. And now he tries to get it across the bowl. Great pressure with the stick. And mercifully, now just seconds left in this one. Into the offensive zone. Makes a move in front. And the lane's clogged up blocking that. Right in front. And they can't convert on the play. Stops him cold. Off a stick. Off the outside of the post and stays out. There's the whistle. Let's get the call from the officials.
A bad night gets worse here. I think this is a frustration penalty. This night can't end quick enough.
The Hurricanes take possession on the faceoff. Kelowna's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. Fires it on net and doesn't go. And they score! And we've seen this act before, Racer.
You get in that close and he's got the puck. Good night. He doesn't miss from there. Great example here of close quarter zone ability, James. In tight, you have to still deliver that puck accurately. It's done to perfection.
The Rockets win possession here in the open ice. Can't find his man. Slides the puck to Lamb. Here they come on the attack. And he puts that one aside with ease. Receives the pass. Fowler's got it in the corner. He scores! Aye, aye, captain!
Is what allowed him to get the play moving and help his teammates finish the job on that goal.
That's it. There's the final horn to close this one up.
Well, you always enjoyed a good challenge. What do you make of this one?
Well, if you're going to lay it down, you better be able to back it up. And they did that. That's a solid game for them.
Do you want to earn some custom World of Chell gear? The best way to do so is by playing more games and earning more hockey bags. Whether you're solo or with the squad, make sure you hit the ice to earn more rewards. Welcome back to the World of Chell. There's been some great challengers on the Pro-Am ranks, giving the pros a run for bragging rights. If you think you can take them, then you should definitely challenge a superstar in his squad.
Thank you.
a gorgeous night. Fans are amped up. I am too. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready for all the action. Both teams lined up in the middle. We are ready to get things underway. And there's the puck drop. Enough talk. It's time to find out what this is all about. And they won't connect on that one. Here's a shot. Blocked aside. He scores! Jumps right on us. A rebound and puts it in the back of the net.
James, that puck's on and off his stick in a hurry, and you have to deliver it fast if you're that close to the net.
Philadelphia's won the draw in the neutral zone. Turns it over. Nice pass. That pass doesn't go. Errant pass, and they can't connect. Takes it and looks ahead. Hangs onto the puck. Toronto's got a hold of it along the wall. Complete the pass. Taken along the wall by Coffey. Passes the puck over to Fowler. Quick pass to Fisher. Takes a shot. And there's the save. No, he scores. He thought he had it, but it must have gone off him. It's in the net, and that's a goal.
Zone. He's got the puck on the string. The defender reaches, makes the mistake, and gets beaten. Now the goalie's got no chance.
Moves it quickly over to Martin. Slides the puck across to Kidd. Here's a shot. Blocked in traffic. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck. Here's a blast from the boards. Denies him with a save. And that's some great pressure in the offensive end by Fowler. Shaw's got the puck in his own zone. Can't connect on the pass. Handles the puck. Oh, somebody get the smelling salts after that.
As the coach told us before the game, they want to set a physical tone. There's a good hit early.
Here's a short pass to Martin. Referee signaling for a penalty. Looks like we got a hooking call coming up. Here comes the official's decision.
I could hear the coaches were frustrated with that. They just want the player to keep his stick on the ice. Instead, he takes a hooking penalty.
And the power play unit takes to the ice their first chance to try to make something happen in this game.
You want to win the special teams battle almost every night. Well, the power play's first chance to check in here. We'll see what they can get done.
Hasek's opted to hang on to the puck for a faceoff. Fisher's recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. And that pass can't connect. Knocked away in the offensive zone. And a stick break set up.
All you button masses just getting rocked.
This is demolition. Derby night after that collision. Puck cleared from the defensive end. And they get the puck out. The Oil Kings don't have time on their side with this power play running out. Toronto's got the puck against the boards. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. The Oil Kings squander a golden opportunity to take the lead here.
Then nobody's going to be very happy about that one, James. No real chances generated. No momentum game. Just a couple of minutes roll off the clock.
Past the midway mark of the frame, we are all tied up in this one. The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here.
Once you ice the puck, you got a few fatigued guys on the ice. This draw is important.
Boom, got it in the offensive zone. Oh, makes the save. That was a rocket. Centers gliding up to the faceoff dots here. Off the draw, and a nice job locking up his opponent. And not much on that one. Shot attempt completely fails on that. Philadelphia's got it, and they're on the attack. And that's picked off in front. Look out, here they come on the attack. A chance! Comes up with the block. Absolutely fearless. And the goaltender manages to get a pad on that one. Trying to engage a little physicality here. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. The Hurricanes take it along the wall. Toronto's got the puck along the wall. Philadelphia's got it in the neutral zone. Slides the puck over to Fisher. Maintains possession. Nice save from point-blank range. Late goings of this period. We got a tie game. Shaw's won it in their own end. Takes the pass as he banks it off the wall. Moves it to Shaw. We got a penalty coming up on the play as the referee extends his hand in the air. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
I used to try this play where you slow the guy down, bump off him, and then skate away. But if you're too slow, you go sit in the box for two.
Toronto's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
You can really only drop the power play so many times. The key is don't lose your confidence in it when it doesn't succeed. Just get right.
There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Play blown dead. Let's get the call.
Just trying to make a defensive play here. Pretty good position, but the stick gets into the player's feet, and the trip is going to be called.
A nice little break for the defenseman here. One less forward to deal with as we have some four-on-four hockey on tap.
Four-on-four opens up a whole new ballgame. Lots of room to carry the puck.
Boom's going to play it against the half wall. Justin's got it into offensive territory. Stays with it. From the right side and up the middle. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Too much congestion in front. Centering pass! And that was blocked! And there's the whistle as he elects to slow things down a little.
A pretty good decision here with the play starting to break down in front of him.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame. Looks like there's a delayed penalty being called here by the officials. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
This is becoming a team-wide discipline issue here. That's their third penalty of the period.
Toronto's got a 4-on-3 power play, but not a lot of time to work with. And a solid job tying up his opponent. Toronto's got it now. The Oil Kings get nothing here on this power play. We're back to even strength. Penalty expires and the PP unit gets set to go to work. Denies him on the play. There's the buzzer. Fans seem to enjoy that first 20 minutes. We'll get to the second period right after both teams get a chance to catch their breath. Stick around. Shane Cebulski, Ray Ferraro bringing you all the action. Period number two is about to go. Toronto's power play is still intact as this period is now underway, and they take possession. And they clear that puck. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. Moves it on over to Kidd. Quick feed to Shaw. Philadelphia's regained possession of the puck. Toronto's got a hold of it against the wall. Great reach with the stick in the neutral zone by Coffey. Quick pass to Shaw. Stopped by the goaltender.
They work the puck into a scoring spot, get a pretty good chance on goal. They just can't find a way to finish it off.
And now it's grabbed by Fowler. And they cough it up at center. Philadelphia's gained possession along the boards. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Toronto's got it along the wall. Picked up along the boards by Kidd. With the puck inside the defensive zone. And a good heads-up defensive play in the open ice. Grabs control of it at the point. The Oil Kings looking against the half wall. Insert. Oh, bar out! It stays out!
Oh, I like that shot, James. He delivered it quickly and beat the goaltender clean. But it rings off the bar, and the game's tied still.
Picked up along the wall by Coffey. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. The Oil Kings will play it in their own end. Poked away in the defensive end. Forces the turnover in the defensive zone. Can't get it to go. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Moves it quickly over to Coffey. Nice poke check. Grabs it in his own end. There's a hit on the play. And he totally whiffs on that one. And they continue to apply pressure here. Grabbed along the boards by Coffey. Slides the puck over. And that's off a stick. The Oil Kings take it along the wing. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. Into the attacking area from the left side. And that one's broken up. Taken by Coffey. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Puck picked up by Martin. The Hurricanes gain control of it. Philadelphia's got it along the wall. Skates in behind the cage. Scores! Oh, what a finish on his part!
Great hands, and you know that the player is confident when they can pull this move off in so tight. What a great play! And he finishes it by beating the goaltender.
He made a great move to get in and score there, guys. That's his puck on a string zone ability. And it's just so entertaining to watch.
Justin's got the puck now here inside his own defensive zone. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Toronto's got it in their own zone. And puts the body into it, a little bumper car hockey. And that banks off a stick. And they keep the pressure on. From the neutral zone now. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck now. Fowler's carrying it ahead. Takes the feed. And that goes wide. He got all of that hit on the play. Textbook stop by Hasek. Puck grab by Boog. Throws it in. Picked up along the wall by Fowler. Off target.
So frustrating. You do all this work, you get it into a good spot, and you don't get it on the net.
Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Moves the puck down low. Moves right to the middle, and that's picked off. The Hurricanes move to the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Coffey. Denies him! There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Getting into the later stages of this period, Philadelphia's got the momentum with a one-goal lead. They'd love to add to that. Here's a shot! Nothing doing!
No, he's got to get that on target. That's a scoring chance, and he doesn't even make the goaltender make a save.
Sends it over to Kidd. Things starting to get a little physical out there. Reads it perfectly, breaking up the play. Moves it to Fisher. Oh, what a stick save!
gets himself in such good position here, uses his body to shield the defender away and is able to hold the puck long enough to get himself into a scoring position. This is a good save by the goalie, though.
And there's the horn bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. Period action. Are you ready? I'm ready. Ray's ready. The players are ready. Let's go. Moment of truth for one team. Here we go. Third period is underway. Ray, with two periods in the books, what are your thoughts on the game to this point?
Toronto's had such a meager total of shots on goal. Predictably, they haven't scored. They've got to get more pucks to the net.
Here's the chance on the attack. Wrist one in close. He scores! They've tied it up!
Brand new game. All that work has gone behind this, and we're back to even Steven. Hey, we get a good look here where the man advantage break is cultivated. Now they've got it clean in. They don't make a mistake, and the goalie has no chance as it's in the net.
Puck is dropped, and we are back underway. Philadelphia's on the attack. Takes the pass. Along the half wall with the puck. Philadelphia's looking to break out. Quick feed to Poole. And that's poked away by Shaw. Toronto's got the puck along the boards. He got robbed again.
He's got to get his head up here. They're going to be carting him off the ice.
Read that perfectly with the poke check. Icing is the call. We'll get a reset. Lots of hockey left to be played in this period. It's all tied up. Locks them up on the draw as they take possession. Reads it perfectly and comes up with the takeaway. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Takes the pass as he banks it off the wall. Here's the pass! And that one's broken up. Handles the puck at the point. And no luck on that pass attempt. And that's knocked away. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. From the point, they take control of it. Philadelphia's got it along the wall. Shuts it down.
Hobby Boulin's helping out everybody here. The defense doesn't have to worry about the front of the net anymore. The puck's in the corner.
Philadelphia's got the puck inside the defensive zone. The Oil Kings have it now. Moves it around along the half wall. Jabs the puck away. Toronto's got possession of the puck. Martin's got it across the line. And that's a great defensive heads up to force the turnover. Toronto's got the puck. Simple stop by Hasek. Sends the pass down low. And reads the play perfectly and picks off the pass. Long reach breaks up the momentum. And now he moves it to Poole. He scores!
Three goals. The hat trick's in the bag. Here come the hat. What a great feeling as this place is jumping. Enough time to wind up for the slapper, and he zips it past the goaltender on the stick side.
He can make those crisp, accurate passes, and we saw it on that play, guys. His tape-to-tape superstar ability helped set up that goal, and he's got the assist.
Close, one of the game's better shooters. You cannot leave him alone. He does not miss there.
We look at this goal again, James, and you notice how close he can get to the net, but how accurately he delivers the puck. That's a tough one for the goalie to handle.
Guys, as we just saw, he does not need a lot of space to get in those goals. He used that close quarter zone ability, and oh my goodness, what a goal.
Off a stick, and they can't connect. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. The Hurricanes have all the momentum right now, leading by two. Sends a pass over. Knocks the puck away in the open ice. And now he moves it quickly to Kidd. Sends the pass over. Puck scooped up. And here comes the pushback.
Fisher's ready to go. Apparently the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Toronto's looking to break out of their own end. Dishes it to Martin. And they cough it up in the neutral zone.
Philadelphia's coaches had talked about stick positioning to us before the game. There's a great example. They've done it all night.
The Oil Kings gain control of the puck. Quick pass to Shaw. Takes the feed. And that's intercepted by Bode. Justin's got it now deep inside his own end. Here's an odd man rush. Comes up with a monster save in front.
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good save in close.
Kidd's been looking for the door here to get off the ice after he was injured in the middle of this shift.
In the final moments of this period, it's a two-goal lead here tonight. 4-2 is where we're sitting. And that shot dies in traffic. Oh, and he whiffs. And they can't connect. Right out in front. And they can't connect. He scores!
Second one. It's such a rush.
Thinking Hattie yet?
Oh, he should be. I mean, he's got two in the bag already. I'll tell you one guy that would be thinking Hattie. Me.
He's so good when he gets near the net like that, guys. That's his close quarter zone ability, and he made a great shot to get one past the goaltender.
Thunder is hit.
Well, that's inevitable. He had his head down, got hit so hard he dropped the stick. Now he's got to go pick it up before he can join the play again.
That's why coaches say keep your head up, right?
That's one of the reasons. Now you don't have to build a new hotel every time you have the puck. Just get the thing forward. Don't turn it over. Don't make a mistake that allows him to come back and push against your team.
Coffey stick handling in his own zone. Toronto's got the puck here in the open ice. Takes a hit on the play. And that carries off a stick. Philadelphia's got it from behind the net. Oh, he keeps it out with a great reactionary stop with the toe. And now it's grabbed by Fowler. Oh, absolutely hammers him. There's the horn, and it's time to breathe. Well, at least definitely for him, a where-were-you moment in EASHL history. He gets his first win with a new team. That's got to be huge mentally, Razor.
It is for sure, James. I mean, they bring you in to try and be part of the solution. They bring you in because they have a need and goal for somebody to make some stops. He was terrific, and he's earned that first win, and that goes a long way in the room.
quite believe in your complex mind. Never quite belong in your complex heart. Felt too tightly squeezed by your complex arms. Could not breathe. Never could quite see all the complex signs. Never could quite read in between your lines. Never felt quite safe in these complex times. Not quite free.
Looking to brush up on some individual skills? Well, you can put effort into both offense and defense by playing some games of ones. It's three skaters and a goalie battling it out for the ultimate bragging rights. It's definitely worth the challenge.
What are you waiting for?
of Chell, and it's Carlin Bathe here with you. I just witnessed a game with an incredible celly, the sliding dab. You know you're having fun scoring when you bust out celebrations like that. You love to see it, so keep scoring out there.
Welcome, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski to this EA Sports Showdown, and we are fired up. Let's drop the puck already. We are about set to drop the puck as both centers make their way into the dot. Puck is dropped. Let's do this hockey. To his teammate. Philadelphia's got a hold of it along the wall.
Monster hit.
Huge open ice hit. Trying to get out of the defensive end. Washington's gained possession along the boards. Takes the puck into the corner of the offensive end. Philadelphia's got it behind the net. Oh, a violent collision against the wall.
No matter what you do, that's never going to feel good.
Can't connect. Scores.
Oh, quickly, the road team gets an upper hand here. And always a little more uncomfortable for the home team when they have to play from behind.
before you hit the ice, make sure you check out the challenge cards to earn exclusive prizes. These rewards are set for a limited time, so you know these challenges are worth fulfilling. Go take a look.
And we are about set to drop the puck tonight. There's been a healthy buzz for this one. Now it's time to see if it lives up to the hype. Gaius moves the puck. Philadelphia's got it in their own zone. Gaius has it from behind his own net. Trying to clear the puck. We got a stoppage. Let's get the call.
Even though he's not very happy here, James, I don't really know what his defense is. That's a penalty to me.
Here's the first look at the power play.
Oh, I love playing on the power play. It's my favorite thing I did. So here you are in a scoreless game. These guys can't get on the ice fast enough for their first opportunity.
Sends it in deep. Washington's got the puck in their own end. Receives the pass. Moves it quickly over to Sabretooth. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. Washington's got the puck against the half wall. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. A chance! Misses just up and over. Trying to exit the defensive zone, and they get it down.
Yeah, good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice. Gaius can't wait to get back into the play.
We've got icing on the play. Faceoff coming up. Still plenty of time left in this frame. We've still got zeros on the board. Fisher's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone.
They've got a tired group against them. That win sets up an offensive play.
Washington's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. Hasek's got the puck and he's going to hang on. More than half the period left to play. We're still scoreless. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Nice zone entry on the left side. Here's a short pass to Fowler. And it's poked away in the neutral zone. Nice heads-up play there. Feeds it over to Ammon. Here's a shot. Oh, what a stop. Here's a shot. Oh, it stops him again.
Gonna have to work a lot harder to beat him tonight, I guess. There's two excellent saves in a row.
Muffs the shot attempt. Philadelphia's going to play the puck.
Evisceration!
Knocked away by Carter. Gets the puck over to Ammon. Now a quick pass to Carter. And that's a great read to force the turnover. That pass doesn't go. Offside the call. We'll get a reset. Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Nice job tying up his opponent. Errant pass and they can't connect. Almost lost
Monster
the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. Nice zone entry from the middle. Taken by Carpenter. With possession along the wall. Here in the corner, he grabs the puck. Philadelphia's got control. He might have a step here. Scores! Clinical!
Once you escape the pack, it's now one-on-one with the goalie. He's trying to read you, you're trying to read him. The shooter wins this time.
And play resumes as the puck is dropped. And that's off a stick. Washington's got the puck. Snaps it on net. And that goes off a player in front. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Past the midway mark in this period, Philadelphia's ahead 1-0. Washington's won the draw. Scooped up along the wall by Carter. Loves the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. Carter's got it against the boards. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Great reach with the stick by Carter. And now he angles it across to Gaias. Pass back to the point. And too much traffic in front blocks that one. And he slides it quickly to Carter. Gains the zone on the left wing. Sends it across. Here's an offensive chance. And they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. Directs it on over to Carter. Great read with the stick. And a great save. Philadelphia's got the puck along the wall. Great reach with the poke check. First period nearly in the books here. Looking for space inside the D zone. Takes the feed from his own end. And that's broken up. Moves it to Carpenter. Picks up the puck in his own end. Here's a shot. That's blocked by Hasek. Official signals as he is about to drop the puck. Here's a shot! That'll do it for period number one. We'll drop the puck on the second period in just moments. Along with Ray Ferraro between the benches, I'm James Cebulski. Period number two is about to get underway. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Pushes it across to Boog. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Dumps it in. Philadelphia's got the puck along the boards. Nice pass. Great save by the goaltender who was in the right place at the right time. Moves the puck along the half wall.
Monster hit!
Laying the body. And that's picked off in the defensive end. Philadelphia just got the puck inside the defensive zone. Washington's got a hold of it against the wall. Errant pass, and the play's broken up. Philadelphia's got the puck along the wall. Washington's looking to break out of their own end. Oh, did he eat that hit?
This is a good time to be retired.
Quick cross-ice pass to Boog. He grabs the puck here at the point. Carter's got it in the defensive end. Here's a chance to make something happen inside the neutral zone. Quick feed to Fowler. One-on-one with the goaltender. Big time stop on the break. Oh, getting a little cheeky there.
Fowler's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
Still lots of time left in the period. Philadelphia's up 1-0. Washington's won the faceoff deep in their own end. And now he passes up to Ammon. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone. That's off a stick. There's the whistle as the play was offside. Centers gliding up to the faceoff dots here. Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Quick pass to Fisher. Washington's got the puck now. The Thunderbirds looking against the half wall. Justin's got it in the defensive zone. Couldn't complete the pass. Moves it quickly over to Justin. He got all of that hit. Hammond's lugging the puck. Oh, just a great heads-up play by Boog. And they won't connect on that one. The Thunderbirds take possession in the defensive end. Working the puck deep inside their own end. Through center along the wing. Can't connect on the pass. There's the whistle icing the call. Past the midway mark of the frame. We got a 1-0 game to this point. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Wicked slap shot! Great defensive effort there. The Thunderbirds carry it along the wall. And he slides it quickly to Carpenter. And that pass can't connect. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Fowler. And that's offside, stopping the play. Washington's won the draw. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Here's the chance to set up now. Getting a little too physical to maintain possession. Referee Shilovec's hand is in the air. We've got a penalty coming up. Steps into it. Just wide.
Tough to generate a rebound even when the puck misses the net by that much.
And now it's grabbed by Carpenter. Scooped up along the wall by Carter. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone.
On the box.
And things start to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Washington's going to... And on the heels of that big hit, he's being called out.
Fisher's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
The Thunderbirds send their man advantage unit out once more.
They might not get too many chances better than this, James. Down a goal and a critical power play.
And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. And they get that puck down the ice. From behind his own cage, he grabs the puck. Turns it over. Washington's got the puck in their own end. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Offside the call. We'll get a faceoff coming up. Can they capitalize on this power play? Here comes the faceoff. Great read by the winger to take possession with the two centermen tied up. Justin's moving the puck through his own zone. Gets it out of his own end. Tosses it to Carter. Takes control of the puck. Tees it up from the point. Great save with the stick. Here comes the pushback.
Carpenter's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
And we'll reset things after that icing.
Oh, it looked like he took a big hit there. Let's get another look at that. I think he's shaking up.
Here in the late going of the frame, 1-0 the score. Ice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Washington's got control of it now from their own end. Moves the puck to Justin. Takes the feed. And with that, two periods now in the books. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports, and we got the third period coming at you in moments. It's about to go down. Period number three. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready to bring you the action. Here we go. Put up or shut up for both teams here in this third period. We
are monster.
He clearly doesn't like that.
Fisher's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks.
Canes get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
They've worked on the power play a lot in practice over the last couple of days. This is their first one tonight, and they'll want to execute what they've worked on, which is to win the draw and start moving the puck.
Pass across to Poole. The Hurricanes carry it along the wall. Lugs the puck back into the neutral zone. They go on the attack through center. And now it's over to Poole. Sacrifices the body. Gains control of the puck here on the blue line. Philadelphia's on the attack. Feeds it down low. Puts it up front. He scores!
Now the power play comes through. They move the puck nicely, and they're able to capitalize on the extra man. I love this play, James, because it's the strength that keeps the play alive as they're trying to shove him off the play. Yet he still sees that there's another play involved, and he makes the pass, and it's in the net.
Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Into the offensive zone. Here's a shot! Makes the save with the chopper! Emmons got it through center. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Scores! The captain delivers! Deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. Washington's got a hold of it along the wall. Gets a hold of the puck from the right side. The Hurricanes have it from their own end. And he regains control of the puck. Oh, a clutch save!
Oh, he's turned away there, James. I mean, that's his money spot, in tight. He's known to score from there.
Right up the gut, here they go. The Thunderbirds gain possession along the wall. Philadelphia's got the puck. Here's a short pass to Fisher. Puck picked up by Boog. The Hurricanes have it behind the net. Quick feed to Carter. Poked away at center ice. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck now. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Carter. Across the line. Philadelphia's got the puck. Move to the middle. Washington's got control of the puck. Manages to hang on. Oh, look at this chance. Let's it fly. Great save by the goaltender to get a pad on that one. Keeping the puck out of the net. Past the halfway mark of this period, Philadelphia's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. Emmons won the draw. And that one's turned away. Hasek's got it, and he'll elect for the whistle.
Jumped on it pretty quickly there, and like everything else tonight, he's really looked in control. He's had an excellent game.
Both teams readying here for the faceoff. Washington's got it, and they're on the attack. The Thunderbirds take it from the side. And they can't convert on the play. Moose it to Poole.
These games used to drive me crazy. As somebody that was supposed to score, there'd be chances all over the place. You wait for one goal or two goals that crack the game open. They never seem to come. The chances are there. The production is not.
Feeds the puck up to Fowler. Knocked away. And that's poked away by Carpenter. And the puck skips away after a nice defensive deflection. Poked away by Carter. Trying to get it down the ice. Big defensive play on that clear.
Now puck's got to get out, especially late. He does a nice job here.
Washington's got it in their own zone. Makes his presence known on the ice. Philadelphia's got the puck along the wall. Gets it over to Ammon. And that pass can't connect. Philadelphia's got it in the neutral zone. Can't connect on the shot. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Into the corner of the attacking area. And a bad pass, and they'll be forced to start all over again outside the offensive end. Slides it diagonally to Fowler. And there we go. Icing is the call. Just here in the late stages of this frame, it's 2-1. Snatches the puck with the two centermen locked up. Nearing the final 60 seconds in this one. Scores! What finish! It was like the puck was on a string!
So good in that position where you drag the defender in tight where they think they've got a real chance to stop the play. And then you make one more move. What a great play and a great finish. So good handling the puck. When he gets that puck in the zone, he's got the puck on a string. The defender reaches, makes the mistake, and gets beaten. Now the goalie's got no chance.
And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Takes the puck at the point. Love that hit.
Well, that's a big hit. I didn't realize how big it was till that helmet hit the ice. You can hear it from
here. The Hurricanes get a hold of the puck in their own end. There's the whistle. Let's see what the referee saw.
Two penalties in a period is tough to explain away to the coaches. He's going to try, but it's not going to work.
Another scoring opportunity looms here. Offense is on faceoff, and he wins the draw. Washington's got possession while undermanned. Emmons got it in the offensive end. Picked off. Works it across to Poole. Moves the puck along the half wall. Washington's got a hold of it against the wall. Moves the puck. Oh, what a stop as he uses his paddle to swat it away.
Nice move by the goalie to get out close to the shooter.
Puck dumped in. Washington's got a chance to work the transition game now shorthanded. First words, and in this particular case tonight, Ray, first win with his EASHL club, or at least his new one anyway.
Well, you could see from his reaction, James, how much this means to him. I mean, you're always nervous when you go to a new team. You want to fit in. You want to be part of the group.
Well, the best way, the quickest way to be part of the group is to do something on the ice that helps out. His first win, a solid performance. The team has to be happy with their new guy in the net.